Welcome to the first video of this series about object-oriented programming and classes in Python. In this video, you're going to learn what a class is and how to define it, how to create an instance of that class, and also the difference between class and instance variables. So, first of all, what is a class? So a class is a way to bundle data together and create objects, okay? Every time we create an object using a class, we call it an instance of that class. And in this video, I'll be using instance and object interchangeably to refer to the same thing, so keep that in mind. So let's say we want to make a class to create different person objects. To define a class, we need to use the class keyword and then the name of the class capitalized. So something like that, class, and then person, like that. So this is how you actually define a class. Then you can write a doc string that describes the class. This is optional, but in my opinion, really important. So you can do something like a person class. Of course, you will write something else, but it's just to show you. Then you can add also variables to the class. So something like name, John, and then age, for example, 40. In this case, name and age are shared with all the instances of the class, and we'll see what this means in a minute, okay? So now we have a class defined, but how can we create instances of this class? We just need to call it as if it were a function, and we need to assign it to a variable, something like this. So person1, the variable person1, and person, we call person like that, and this creates an instance of the person class, and we can create another variable like person2. So we've got two objects or instances of the class person, one in person1 variable and the other one in the person2 variable. Okay, so once you've created the instances, you can actually access the value of their attributes simply using the dot notation. So you can do something like print person1.name and then print person2.name. And of course, these are both John. So if we run that, you can see that you get John and John, of course, because actually you've got the same name. So as I said, name is a class attribute, which means that we don't have a string name for person1 in memory and a string name for the person2. So two strings in memory, we don't have them. We just have one string object in memory that is shared. And this shared string object is basically the name variable of the class itself, and we can see its memory ID like this. So something like print id person.name. As you can see, I'm not using the instances. I'm actually using the class itself, person, like that, okay? And we can also print the IDs of person1.name and the ID of person2.name, something like that. And if we print them, you can see that you get the same exact ID, which means that person.name, person1.name, and person2.name point to the same object in memory. In simple terms, when you access the variable name of one of the instances, Python will get the name attribute of the class itself. Let's make a simple visual representation that is not actual Python code, but just so that you can actually understand it better. Okay, so we've got something like, I'm gonna use a comment. So when you access person1.name, you're actually pointing to person.name, which is equal to John in this case. And you do the same thing here. Okay, so as you can see, they both point, so you've got these two, but they both point to this person1.name in memory, which is just one. So if we change the value of the class person name and we do something like person.name David, like that, in our representation, we get something like this. They still point to the same person.name, but we've changed it. So now they both actually need to add that, okay? So actually here we've got David and David, because this is actually the same one. So already from this, you can tell that all instances will use the value David instead. But if you want to confirm that, you can do something like, let's print a little separator, okay? Like that, and then you can print. And actually get those from here. You can print person.name and then those two like that. And also we can print all the IDs as we did earlier. So we've got the person1.name, person2.name, and the IDs before, and then we change it, and then we've got them after. So let's actually run that. Okay, so as you can see, they still have the same exact ID, but this is different from this. So they are different IDs, but all the attributes have the same ID, which means that we still have just one string in memory, although we are actually using three ways to get it. Okay, so as you can see here, you're using person.name, person1.name, person2.name, but they all point to the same exact object in memory, as you can see here. I hope that makes sense. So this could actually be a nice trick to change the value of a variable to a new one, even after some instances have already been created. Like for our person1 and person2 instances, you've already created them, and by using person.name David, you change the value for all the instances, the ones that have been already created and the ones that will be created. So let's delete all of this like that. Perfect. We are going to keep these two instances. So if we change the value using the instance like this, if you do something like person1.name Jack, for example, something like that. In this case, Python will create a new variable, which is called instance variable, which is not the class variable anymore. And this variable is unique to this specific instance, and Python will use that value instead. So a visual representation could be something like person1.name is now equal to Jack, and person2.name is still equal to person.name, which is still John, like that. So now, as you can see, person1.name is not pointing to person.name anymore, but has its own value, while person2 still points to the person.name, as you can see here, which is still John, because we actually didn't assign a new value to it. And so basically we have now two objects in memory, one object, Jack, and one object, John. Of course, now, if we were to change the value of person.name, the change would not affect person1.name, but only person2, because now person1.name is a completely separated variable, because Python in this case sees that there is a person1.name, an instance variable with the string Jack, and then there's a class variable name, and this is used instead. So when you've got an instance variable with the same name as a class variable, the instance variable is used, okay? So, as I said, if you change now person name to Joe, for example, then you get something like this. So person1.name is still Jack, okay, because this is a completely different variable. And person2.name points to this, which is now Joe. So you get Joe here. And we can actually see the actual result by doing something like print person.name, and then person1.name and person2.name. If we actually print that, you can see that Joe, Jack, Joe, because person, these two are the same. This one is an instance variable and has a different value. So far we've just replaced the value of an existing class variable, but we can also create a new class variable like this. So let's delete it like this. Perfect. We can do something like person.new class variable class, something like that. Of course, this is just a name that I made up, but you can use whatever. And now you can access it from all instances because we've added using the class directly like that. So new class variable person2 like that. And if we run that, you can see that you get class variable and class variable. So basically, if you add a new class variable like this, it's like you were adding that here, like that, basically. So this is accessible from all the instances. But of course, you can also create a new instance variable. So here we've created a class variable, but we can do something like person1.new instance variable And we can do something like this, okay? This would create a new instance variable only for person one. So all the other instances won't have access to that variable. So if you were to use person two dot new instance variable, you would get an error because person two doesn't have this instance variable. So this is unique to person one. So now I'm going to tell you something really important. So listen up. So far we've used strings, which are immutable objects, and I've actually made a video on mutable and immutable objects. So after this video, go and watch it if you want to learn more about it. So as strings are immutable objects, we are forced to assign a new value to the variable to change it. So in this case, if you want to change the variable name, you need to do something like person.name and the new value. You need to do something like that. So you're assigning a new value to the class variable person.name. So every time we assign a new value to a class variable using an instance, it becomes an instance variable unique to that instance, as we saw earlier. So if you do something like person1.name new value, this becomes an instance variable unique to person1. But things get tricky when it comes to mutable objects, like lists, for example, because you can actually add and remove items from them without assigning a new value to the variable. But before we get to that, give this video a like and subscribe to get notified when the other videos of this series come out. Also, if you want to support me even more, leave a comment. I really love to read them. So let's say that we have a class variable languages. Let's add it here, languages. So we've got a list, something like that. And let's say that we want to add to this list English, but just for person one. So you might think that you can do something like person1.languages.append, and then you do something like English. So here you might think we've just created a new instance variable for person one, right? Wrong. We didn't actually assign a new value to person1.languages. So that means that we've actually added English to the shared list. And in fact, if we print something like and then person.languages, okay, and also person2.languages, and we run it, you can see that you get English and English. So you actually added the English string to the shared list, to the shared class variable, and not just to the list, the languages list of person one. And this, of course, wouldn't have happened if we had done something like this. So if we had done something like person one, dot languages is equal to English. Here, we are actually assigning a new list to person1.languages, and this would create a new instance variable just for person1. But here, we're not assigning a new value to the person1.languages variable. We're actually just appending something to it, which means that we are modifying the shared variable and not creating an instance variable. So this is really, really important. So now that we've got this, if we do something like person1.languages.append, and we want to add something like, let's say, Japanese, let's actually get this and print that down here. So if you print that, as you can see, you still get just English in person, in the class itself, and person2. But if you print person1.languages, you get English and Japanese, because by assigning this new list to person1.languages, we created a new instance variable, which is separated from the actual shared class variable, okay? So I think that by now you've got the point, and you should know when you should use the class attributes, like for constants that never change, things that you want to change for all instances in a future moment, as we did earlier when we used like person.name to change the name for all the instances. And also you can use the class attributes for default values that can be changed instance by instance. So like you can have like name, just a default value of John, for example, or maybe anonymous, something like that. And then you can change it instance by instance, keeping in mind the immutable object thing. So this thing here, like when you have a mutable object as an attribute. So in this case, name, age, and languages shouldn't actually be shared class attributes. They should be instance attributes unique to a specific instance, and we should be able to specify them when creating its instance. So instead of having to do something like person one like that, person two like that, and then having to do something like person1.name and then the new name, then person to the name, etc., etc., etc. It would be nice to be able to actually specify the name, the age, etc., when you create an instance. And this is actually possible using the init method. And luckily, it's part of what I'm going to talk about in the next video of this series, where you learn about methods, self-init, class methods, and a lot of good stuff. So if the next video is already out, you should see it on the screen, along with the playlist containing all the videos of this series. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. And I'll see you soon. Bye.